Hey folks, this is a really exciting time to be a Python user. The first beta of Python 3.13 came out recently, and it includes a couple of new features that have been attracting a lot of attention. One of them is the new experimental just-in-time JIT compiler, which speeds up code automatically. The other is the free threading function that shows how Python can work without the global interpreter lock, or the GIL as it's called, and this will allow CPU-bound code in different threads to run with true parallelism. The bad news is neither of these features are enabled in Python by default. You have to compile a custom build of the 3.13 interpreter to use either of them. Plus, you can't use them both at the same time. You can only enable one or the other. So I took some time over the last couple of days to compile versions of Python 3.13 that use the new JIT and that enable free threading, or the no-GIL mode, as it's also called. And the results are definitely worth a look. Now, to test out both the free threading and the JIT operations, I have here a synthetic benchmark that is heavily CPU dependent. I want to emphasize this is not something that reflects a real-world workload. It's just meant to provide a stress test that we can get dramatic results from. I have three different programs that use this same test. One of them just runs the test for 1,000 cycles in a single thread. Another version uses a thread pool to split the work across multiple CPU cores. This system has 6 physical cores and 12 threads, so keep that in mind for some idea of how much of a speedup we can expect. And a third version splits the work across a process pool. With Python right now, if we want true parallelism for CPU-bound work, we have to use a process pool rather than threading. Problem is, process pools have a lot of startup and a lot of communication overhead. Threads are much lighter and easier to share data between. So let's begin by running the stock build of Python 3.13 on a single thread. The single-threaded operation will take about 10 seconds to finish on this system. Your results are going to vary, but I want to establish this as a baseline for how 3.13 behaves out of the box on this hardware. Now, let's see what happens when we run a multi-threaded version, but we're still only using the stock version of 3.13. Now, you'll notice that splitting CPU-bound work across threads does not help us here, because the threads are not truly running in parallel. The GIL has to synchronize operations between threads, so any parallelism is lost. This is Python's big obstacle with threads. Now for perspective, let's run the multiprocessing version on the stock version of 3.13. And this version completes many times faster because we're splitting the work across multiple processes, each with its own GIL. The downside is that there's a lot of startup time for the process pool. But the work takes so long to complete, that's not a big issue here. Still, multiprocessing is an imperfect solution at best. So now let's take a look at what happens when we run the single-threaded version using the no-GIL build. And the results are about the same as what we would get with the stock 3.13 version. There's not much change, if any. But that's actually a good thing, because one of the reasons it's been hard to do away with the GIL is because many of the previous efforts around that ended up causing single-threaded operations to be much slower, and the vast majority of Python code is still single-threaded. Now, let's run the threaded version of this program in no-GIL mode, and the results are, to say the least, dramatically faster. They're comparable to what we'd get with process pools, but without the overhead of starting and synchronizing between separate processes. And we get this for nothing more than the cost of switching interpreters. If we're already using threads, we get this for free. Or if we're using process pools, we can migrate to thread pools pretty easily and get that payoff. Now for fun, let's try running the no-GIL version using process pools, just to see what happens. And what we see is about the same magnitude of speedup we'd get from using process pools in the stock version of the interpreter. The point is that we don't have to use process pools to get this kind of speedup anymore. We can just use threading. Now let's take a look at this workload in all of its different incarnations when we feed it into Python's new experimental JIT. And to do this, I needed to make a separate build from the no-GIL edition. I can't have the JIT and no-GIL enabled in the same build, at least not yet. And the idea behind the JIT is to recognize where certain types are being used predictably in code and to replace the bytecode at those locations with specialized versions that speed up operations with those types. And with 3.13, this mechanism has been improved even further. They're still not making any big promises for how much of a speedup you can expect. It's more about building out ways to improve things across the board in the future. But it's still worth seeing how much of a speedup we get right now, so let's try out our single-threaded benchmark and see what we get. And again, I need to emphasize, this is a highly synthetic benchmark that doesn't reflect real-world use. But the single-threaded JITted version runs about 20% faster than the stock 3.13 version. That's not bad at all for doing nothing more than replacing the interpreter. Now, if we run the threaded version, we're not going to see much of a change there because this build, again, does not use free threading. But we still see something of an improvement thanks to the JITting anyway. And if we run the multiprocessing version, we see a speed up there as well over the stock 3.13 interpreter when we use multiprocessing there. And again, that's because to a great degree, multiprocessing is providing most of the speed up, but we're still seeing further differences manifesting thanks to the JIT. So to sum up, while the no-GIL version of Python is still very much an experiment, it's an extremely promising one. Its biggest payoffs will manifest in cases where you had to resort to using multiprocessing for parallelism, since you can now switch to thread pools and remove a lot of the overhead of using processes. But it's going to be a long way before this is provided as a stock option for Python users. So if you want to experiment with the no-GIL edition, you're going to have to build it yourself. The same goes with the new experimental JIT. It's not likely to speed up everything. The examples I've shown here are contrived, but it's about laying a foundation for how Python can be made faster in the future without having to do anything but upgrade the interpreter. And like the no-GIL build, it's only available if you build the interpreter on your own. So, if you're curious about trying either of these out, read up on the build instructions for the Python interpreter, roll up your sleeves, and give it a shot. That's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.